So many say that the best revenge in life is success. And so, sweetheart, when your boyfriend breaks up with you, there's just one way out of this situation. Just one way to live your life. And of course, we're in the month of February 2022, the month of love. As others celebrate love, I'm sure others are crying out of breakups. Others are hurting out of breakups. Others are wondering, you know, what do I do from here? I hope that, you know, this will crystallize into something substantial, maybe even a marriage, but it just didn't happen. Instead, you know, I received a breakup. Instead of receiving a proposal or even a wedding ring, I received a breakup. So how do I go about this? I know many of us ladies don't get this concept yet. It took me years to grasp this concept too, because I used to cry for months, beg, you know, my ex for months. I would even lock myself indoors, you name it. Everything's crazy that people do apart from being suicidal or writing suicidal notes. I've never done that, and you should never allow yourself to reach that, you know, position. Don't ever put yourself in that position as to start writing suicidal notes or even, you know, thinking or having suicidal thoughts, because I think suicide is just the height of it, right? And it's a bad spirit. You should never entertain, never ever entertain suicide. So I've done all these things, and I realized that I was punishing myself for someone else's choice to leave me. Imagine someone has decided to leave you and you start punishing yourself for their choice. So, sweetheart, stop punishing yourself. So the first thing you should do when your boyfriend breaks up with you is analyze your chances. Do you stand a chance of getting back your boyfriend? What's your overall chance of getting him back? And because at this point, I know you will be so desperate to get him back. Obviously, like every woman who has ever encountered a breakup has been in this desperate situation or position to get their boyfriend back. And every man will always regret breaking up with the ungettable girl. The ungettable girl. So what do I mean by the ungettable girl? In my private discussions with many other women via Facebook, most of them defined ungettable as a lady who loves herself, a lady who lives a happy and complete life, a lady who isn't afraid to set her boundaries, you know, prior to the relationship, a lady who is bold enough to communicate her boundaries properly and with a smile, you know, not shouting at your man or what have you, but a lady who is bold enough to communicate her boundaries with a smile, a lady who isn't afraid to uphold these boundaries, and a lady who isn't afraid to lose those that don't respect her boundaries. So every man will always regret, you know, breaking up with the ungettable girl, because this kind of a girl is a rare version of a woman. Most women don't even know themselves so well to understand, you know, their boundaries, to even set boundaries, to even communicate boundaries properly and with a smile. Most women don't do these things. Most women are afraid to lose their boyfriends to an extent that they will just let, you know, someone walk over them and their boundaries in the name of keeping their boyfriends, right? So every man will regret at some point leaving the ungettable girl, a girl who understands herself. What so sweet that when someone breaks up with you, you should really ask yourself if you understand yourself. What another person told me, another lady told me, that an ungettable girl makes men their bitches. Okay, and so how does the ungettable girl react to a breakup? Number one, she assumes his existence and does not contact him, of course. This lady ignores her ex on purpose for a number of days, a period of time, just to allow, you know, her ex to experience life without her, right? And also to allow her to rebuild or reconstruct her life without her ex-boyfriend. Whether she wants him back or not, he will start by ignoring her ex-boyfriend. At the point that this boyfriend breaks up with him, she will automatically ignore him for a number of days, even months, depending on, you know, her situation and who she is and where she is in life. Right? So how this time that she chooses to ignore her boyfriend is important to both her and her ex-boyfriend, right? This time is very important and crucial to both parties. So there are three important stages in ignoring your ex-boyfriend, I must mention. These stages are the before ignoring him, the during ignoring him, and the after ignoring him. So what is the ungettable girl doing, right? During these three stages, after she has been broken up with, what does she do? Of course, she's not writing suicide notes, right? And she's not as well planning to commit suicide because she understands her self-worth. She understands that her life really matters in this world. So during stage one, and stage one is just after breakup and before she starts to ignore her ex-boyfriend, the ungettable girl learns and understands everything about ignoring their ex, depending on her situation. If she has children with the ex, or if she even works with the ex in the same organization. So she takes this time during stage one, which is before she chooses to ignore her ex-boyfriend, she takes this time to learn about and understand what it takes to ignore her ex-boyfriend. Okay, and she also takes this time to determine the length of time that she will need to ignore her ex-boyfriend. This can run from between periods of 21 days to 45 days, all right? Sometimes even 14 days, depending on how quick or how slow, you know, this comes into actualization. So the ungettable girl takes time to determine the length of time that she will be ignoring her ex-boyfriend. And this period, as I said, can run from 14 days to 45 days, even 21 days to 45 days. The last thing that the ungettable girl does during this first stage, you know, before she starts ignoring her ex-boyfriend, is that she takes this time to interpret his actions. She takes this time to interpret her ex-boyfriend's actions, because actions speak louder than words most of the time. You know, many are from the school of thought that when a man breaks up with you, you should stay busy to avoid feeling the pain. But this is risky to me, because now you don't remove the perfect image. You see, most of us have created the perfect image of what we expected from this man beforehand, you know, before they started showing us their negative side. So if you don't take time to actually internalize and process your ex-boyfriend's actions and really, you know, recreate that perfect picture to the real picture of him, and then you're actually risking yourself in some way, I must say that. Because if you don't remove the perfect image of your ex-boyfriend that you created in your mind and replace it with the exact image of who your ex-boyfriend is based on his actions that they have chosen, you should remember that these people choose these actions. They're not forced to. They choose to display these actions to you. So if you do not replace that perfect image with the exact image of your ex-boyfriend based on the actions that they have chosen to show you, and taking some time to reflect on their actions, also puts you in a better, you know, mental space to handle the breakup appropriately, because now you have the real picture of who your ex-boyfriend is. I must say that these stages also apply to marriages on rocks. These stages don't just apply to relationships or boyfriend-girlfriend relationships, even marriages on rocks. You know, if you are a lady in a marriage that is on the rocks, then you should also consider, you know, just reflecting on your ex-husband's actions, so that you remove the perfect picture of what you expected him to be and replace that perfect picture with the real picture of who he really is based on his actions, based on the actions that he has chosen to display to you. That's the image that should be running at the back of your mind before you choose to start ignoring him. So So, sweetheart, don't be so quick to want your ex back before taking some time to reflect on his actions and know if they are, if those actions are acceptable to you based on your personal boundaries. I'm assuming that you have personal boundaries as a person. So when you reflect on your ex-boyfriend's or ex-husband's actions, you know, and changing that perfect image of them that you have on your mind and replacing that image with a real image of them, you know, based on their actions. Are those actions acceptable to you when you go back to your boundaries? Should you tolerate them? After doing all those three things in stage one, and then the ungettable girl focuses on actually improving herself. There are three areas in your life, sweetheart, because I'm talking to you, lady after on God's heart. So there are three areas in your life that you should consider more important than anything else. And these areas are your health, your wealth, and your relationship. And these areas, these three areas are interconnected or intertwined. Because if your relationships are on the rocks, then your health and wealth also follow suit automatically. Let's say your boyfriend breaks up with you, or your husband breaks up with you, or even signs the divorce papers, or even, you know, suggests a divorce seriously. So you take this breakup so hard that you stop caring about your work. You even start stress eating, thus adding up a lot of weight. I used to be in this category, by the way. When I was stressed, in moments that I was stressed, I would overeat and I would add a lot of weight. And, you know, someone will look at you and wonder, you're stressed up, but you're still overeating. So, like, you're supposed, when you're stressed up, you're supposed to not like food. But some of us, I used to like a lot of food. I used to make food my best friend whenever I'm stressed up. So you took this breakup so hard that you stopped caring about your work. You even started stress eating, thus you added a lot of weight. You know, I used to be like this, but now I know better. So can you guess what happens? Of course, your work will start suffering because you skip out of work, out on work. And of course, your social or relationships will start suffering also because you put up a lot of weight. So since the ungettable girl understands the connection between her health, her wealth, and her relationships, and also knows that the synergy can either work negatively or positively to her advantage, she chooses to work on the other two important aspects of her life outside her relationships in case she experiences her breakup. And to improve on them. And these two things are her health and her wealth, right? So instead of stress eating to gain weight, eventually, this ungettable girl actually starts to work out, which results into her losing weight, all right? And gaining more confidence, and which also makes her to work better, you know, and even perform better at her workplace. And guess what? The next thing you know, her friends and family start saying that she's doing pretty much awesome. And trust you me, these statements automatically will reach her ex-boyfriend, who will in turn do what? Definitely, this ex-boyfriend will start calling and contacting her. So spend a lot of time on those two important aspects of your life and raise all the other three aspects of your life all together. So in case someone breaks up with you, channel that energy into becoming a better version of yourself, health-wise and even financially, wealth-wise, and so that when you become a better version of you, then you become more confident and people will start talking. Let people talk for you, by the way. Kizuri chajitembeza kibaya. Kizuri chaji tanga, kibaya chaji tangaza, kizuri chaji tembeza. I think that's the right Swahili proverb. You know, when people start talking about you positively, it will definitely reach your ex-boyfriend and he will contact you. You know, men always come back, you know, to the ungettable girls. Men always come back to the ungettable girls. They don't go back to stressful girls, or girls who don't even understand themselves or their boundaries, or girls who don't have lives. But men always go back and and regret leaving the ungettable girl. So choose to be the ungettable girl by working on your wealth and health whenever you experience a breakup. So what does the ungettable girl do in set three, which is after ignoring her ex-boyfriend? So let's say the ex-boyfriend has contacted her because he has, you know, automatically maybe heard of her improvements, maybe even seen her on social media, somewhere, you know. And so what does the ungettable girl do in stage three, which is after ignoring her ex-boyfriend? So in stage one, where she has determined if she should move on or take her ex back. So here, after ignoring her ex-boyfriend and improving her life, it's important to note that this ungettable girl has definitely even changed mentally, and thus should do another evaluation of if she still wants her ex back. So if she wants her ex back, then she should start treating him like they've just met and start all over again. Of course, reminiscing on the good times, right? So that you don't carry the old drama with you to the new relationship. You just think of the good times that you guys, you know, used to have in the previous relationship and start afresh. So in case you are that or choose to be that ungettable girl, then it's important to note that if you want your ex-boyfriend back, then you should choose to start afresh. You should choose to start anew and just give room, be open, you know, like go out on dates. Of course, don't start from starting from anew, I don't mean until you start by being friends or not. Don't ever accept to be friend zoned by anyone, all right? But starting anew means, you know, carrying the good times only to the new relationship, all right? And starting from that point and know each other afresh, you know, and carry on, you see? And if this ungettable girl doesn't want her ex-boyfriend back, remember, this depends on the ungettable girl's analysis, not on her ex-boyfriend's efforts, all right? If she doesn't want his ex-boyfriend back, then she should channel all her energies to the new relationship, leaving the old dog to lie and die, all right? So you know how the saying goes that another man's trash is another man's delicacy. Yummy, of course, all right? And I must mention that if you choose to act like the ungettable girl after a breakup, you actually got nothing to lose, especially if your intentions were pure from the very beginning of the relationship and even the breakup, all right? And that your ex has all to lose in this situation and scenario. Thank you for watching this video to the very end. I hope you've learned one or two things that you can choose to do in case you experience a breakup. I go by the name Sarah Ayuma, the all-round nutritionist. And please boost my YouTube channel, algorithm, by subscribing below. Click the subscribe button below and boost this channel's algorithm so that this knowledge can be shared, you know, among many other individuals. Thank you for your continued support and see you in my next video.